Democratic Congressman Elijah Cummings of Maryland. He's the ranking member of the House Oversight Government Reform Committee. Congressman, yesterday I spoke with your colleague, the chairman of the committee, Jason Chaffetz. I want you to listen to what he said when I asked him, because he had earlier said he has 2 years of material to investigate Hillary Clinton on all sorts of areas. He said he was going to do so, certainly if she's elected president of the United States. But listen to this. If she's not elected president, are you still going to plan two years of hearings on her?
Absolutely. Look, I'm guessing how long this is going to take. Look at what we did with the Secret Service. I think Elijah Cummings and I came together in a very bipartisan way. We saw a mess that was happening in the Secret Service. That investigation and that cleanup still continues to this day. I'm going to take that same philosophy and approach.
All right, so Congressman, will you work with the chairman, Chairman Chaffetz, to investigate Hillary Clinton, whether she wins or loses over the next 2 years?
I'm going to do my duty and work with the chairman, but I'm hoping that the chairman will do something that's very important here. I'm hoping that he will put country over party, and I'm hoping he'll also be joining with me as we look at these Russian hacks of the DNC, and that we look at the FBI leaks. I hope that he will join me when we look at any relationship that Mr. Trump may have had with regard to the Russian government and possibly doing harm to our electoral process. And so I will work with him, but I also want him, again, to put country over party.
As you also know, there are some other Republicans who are openly now talking about impeachment sure. if Hillary Clinton wins the election. You're a supporter of Hillary Clinton. So tell us how you're going to react if they start impeachment procedures. Presumably, the Republicans will still be the majority in the House of Representatives.
Well, a lot of people don't understand that, Wolf, that they who have power have all power. They literally set the agenda. If the Republicans are in control, and I'm hoping that they won't be, but the fact is that we have to make sure that whatever process comes forward is a fair process. But more significant than that, how in the world, in our democracy, before somebody is even elected, they start talking about impeachment. I still don't know what they are trying to impeach her over. And it reminds me, Wolf, of Mr. McConnell 8 years ago when the first thing he said, I think on inauguration day of Barack Obama, he said that his number one priority was that he not have a second term. Now it's gotten worse, and that really bothers me. Here we are, we're supposed to have a system of government whereby the voters go, they vote, and they make a decision. And then everybody come together after the decision, and again, putting country over party, and do things for the benefit of the American people. Well, when you start off like that, talking about an impeachment before she even gets into office, you know, I think that's a very, very sad day. And again, I think we've got to be very careful with our democracy and guard it, because I'm telling you, from this election has shown a lot. It shows that we've got a presidential candidate that he himself has been talking about impeachment. He himself, a presidential candidate who is seems like he's in love with Mr. Putin, who is not a friend of the United States. And then we see these hacks on our computer systems. And then we see the kinds of things that is going on with regard to the FBI. It's just a lot here. And so I'm appealing to the American people right now. Go out there and vote. This is not about Hillary Clinton. This is not about Donald Trump. This is about our democracy and preserving it. We go around touting democracy, Wolf, all over the world. But if we do not have trust in our systems like the FBI, CIA, and others, then what is it? The rest of the world laugh at us and say, what, you mean that's a democracy? It's not that. We've got to guard it, and I'm going to guard it with everything I've got until the day I die.
Congressman Elijah Cummings of Maryland, as usual, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
I just want to remind everybody.